So a very good morning to all of you. We are here with the lecture in the GATE questions asked in the GATE question paper in the course of electrical power system. So today we are going to solve some of the problems which are asked in the GATE question papers in the recent years, and we will see how these topics are related with the electrical power system engineering. So let us see one by one. We have learned about the positive, negative and the zero sequence reactance diagram, right? Let us see today how this positive, negative and zero sequence reactance diagrams are asked in the GATE examination question paper, so that you all will be able to know that the syllabus which is framed is really helpful to solve the GATE question papers also. And similarly, the other competitive exams which are related to the electrical engineering are having this syllabus on the electrical power system, and this type of questions are asked there also. So let us see the first question. So I request everyone to write this question. This question is asked in the GATE 2011 question paper. So the question is very simple. They have asked two generator units G1 and G2 are connected by 15 kV line with a bus at the midpoint as shown below. So you can see here there is a power system network given to us which comprises of three buses. Bus number 1, bus number 2 and the bus number 3, which is there at the midpoint. So that's why in the question itself, it's written that the bus 3 is in the midpoint. So you can see here the bus 3 is in the midpoint because the line length between the bus 1 and bus 3 is 10 kilometer, as well as the line length between the bus 2 and bus 3 is also 10 kilometer. Then what they have given is G1 is having 250 MVA. 15 kV positive sequence reactance X is equal to 25% on its own base. Then G2 is 100 MVA 15 kV positive sequence reactance X is equal to 10% on its own base. L1 and L2 is equal to 10 kilometer positive sequence reactance X is equal to 0.225 ohm per kilometer. So this is what is the database given to us. In the year 2011, the question paper which was asked, you can go through the question paper, it's already available in the Google media or in the website of any of the IITs. IIT Roorkee generally has all the question papers related to the GATE question paper. So if you will visit the website of IIT Roorkee, you will get almost all the question papers which are of the previous years related to the GATE examination electrical engineering program. So in that year 2011, the two questions were asked based on this particular diagram, and this questions carries 2 marks each. So 4 questions were asked in this particular question. So you can write down, note down this question. We will solve this question. Let us see the first question, what is asked in with the help of this given data. So question number 52 of GATE 2011 paper that we are going to solve right now. So the question is, for the above system, the positive sequence diagram with the per unit value on 100 MVA common base is. So there will be 4 alternatives given to us. We will have to select the correct alternative. So before approaching to the alternative, we should actually solve this question, and then we should start thinking about the alternative. Because you all know, you have already solved this type of problem in unit number 1 as well as in unit number 2. In unit number 1, you all have drawn the positive, negative and the zero sequence reactance diagram. In the unit number 2, you all have solved the numericals related to the symmetrical faults, that is the three phase faults, and in the unit number 3 you all have learnt about the unsymmetrical faults. So whatever the system is, whether it's symmetrical fault, whether it's unsymmetrical fault, the first, very first step that we have to do is we have to draw the reactance diagram. So whatever it is, like in case of a symmetrical fault, we have only the positive sequence diagram, because the negative and the zero sequence are absent in case of the symmetrical fault. Whereas in case of the unsymmetrical fault, all the three components are present, like zero sequence is also present, positive sequence is also present, and negative sequence is also present in case of a line to ground fault. Whereas in case of a double line fault and a double line to ground fault, only the positive and negative sequences are present, zero sequences are not present in case of a line to line fault. So nothing is being asked about the fault, so we will not concentrate on the fault part. What is asked is, we will read the question carefully. What is asked is to draw the positive sequence reactance diagram. So you all have already drawn the positive sequence reactance diagram many times. In unit number 1, you have drawn the reactance diagram. There was a network given to you. Then the values were, data sheet was provided about the various component. Based on that, you all used to draw the positive, negative and the zero sequence reactance diagram as it was asked in the question paper. When it was asked for the positive sequence, negative sequence, you used to draw that. When it was asked only for the zero sequence, you all used to draw for that only. But now here, what they have asked is, they have asked the positive sequence diagram. So I hope you all remember the positive sequence reactance diagram, because we have drawn it several times. So let us again draw it with the help of the given data. So you can see here what is given here. So what is given here? You can see here what are the components that is given. Let us see one by one. So the component, first component is G1, that is generator 1. Second component is generator 2. Third component is transmission line L1. And the fourth component is transmission line L2. So can anyone tell me how many number of components will be there in the sequence diagram? Or in other words, how many parameters you need to calculate in the sequence reactance diagram? Quickly, I need a quick reply. So I have already stated generator G1, generator G2, transmission line L1 and transmission line L2. So how many components do we need to compute to draw the positive sequence reactance diagram? Okay, very good. So 4 components are to be calculated. So what are the 4 components? The first component is related to the G1. The second component is related to G2. Third component is related to the line impedance, that is L1. And the fourth component is related to L2. But then here you can see the line length of both the transmission lines is same, that is 10 kilometer, right? So if you will calculate only for one, that is if you will calculate for the value L1, the same will be the value for the L2 also, right? Am I correct or am I wrong? So whatever value you will calculate for L1, the same value will be for L2. So is it correct or is it wrong? Correct, right? So ultimately we have to calculate only 4 things, sorry, 3 things, because the fourth one is the duplication of the L1 only, right? So first of all, we need to make it clear how many components we need to calculate. So if once we are clear, then we will start one by one the solution of it. So you can see here in the question, what they have given is, you need to take the common MVA or the base MVA as 100 MVA. So please calculate in your copy for the XG1. It's very simple. We have already solved many times. So X they have given as 25%. So if we convert this percent into the per unit value, what will be its value? The per unit value will be 0.25J. So calculate for x g1 and reply on the chat box. Let's see who calculates it correctly, because we will require all these values in order to draw the positive sequence reactance diagram, right? So if we require all these values, we need to calculate it one by one. So first of all, calculate the value for G1. See, the base MVA is given as 100 and the rated MVA of this generator G1 is given as 250. So you all have already calculated this many times. So I expect a quick reply from all of you. So let's see who gives the quick reply for XG1. So make it fast, XG1. Okay, very good. 0.1. What about J, Aniket? You have not posted about J because its all terms are X. So whenever the terms are in X, you have to insert J in it. What about others? Please reply. Only Aniket has replied about 0.1 per unit. Others, please make it quick. Then we will go for XG2. See, it's a very simple question for 2 marks. And you have a limited time, so you need to calculate it fast. And you all have already done it several times in your unit number one as well as unit number two. So I expect the replies from other students as well. Okay, Nitesh also per unit was 0.1J, where you all are skipping the J part. We need the J part also. Okay, so those who are not able to calculate, you will have to wait for some time. After all the components calculation, I will show the calculations how to calculate the different values. So XG1 is calculated. Now let's calculate for XG2. So you can see here XG2, the MVA rated MVA given is 100 and the base MVA is also 100. So calculate for XG2 and reply fast. Calculate for XG2 and reply it fast. What will be the value for XG2? See, because all these values you will require to draw the positive sequence diagram, right? So again, it's J 0.1 per unit, right? So why? Because you can see here X is given as 0.1J. Then we have the rated value or the rated MVA of G2 as 100 MVA. So how do we calculate? 0.1J multiplied by 100 divided by 100. It's very simple, right? So in this way, you will get 0.1J. And then we need to calculate the value for the transmission line. So how do we calculate the value for the transmission line? Do you all remember the technique that we use it? Because see here, the value is given in terms of the ohm per kilometer. And we need the value in terms of per unit. So you can turn back your pages and you can see in your book how we have solved this previously. So when we do this, we require the kV and the MVA. How do we do it then? Can anyone reply? How do we calculate this regarding the transmission line impedance? How do we do this transmission line? Because now it's given in terms of the ohm per kilometer, and we need to convert this in terms of per unit because all the values will be in per unit. So we cannot keep one value in some other unit and the other two values in other per unit system. So we need to convert this also in per unit system. How do we do this? Does anyone remember? Anyone, if you can reply,
Upon kV square.
yes, Dhanashree.
एमवी अपॉन केवी स्क्वायर सर।
एमवीए अपॉन केवी स्क्वायर. ओके, एनीवन एल्स? डू यू ऑल रिमेम्बर दिस? एनीवन एल्स? ओके, सो लेट अस सी हाउ द कैलकुलेशंस विल गो वन बाय वन. राइट, सो लेट अस सी वन बाय वन. सो बेस एमवीए इज 100 MVA. दोज हु आर नॉट एबल टू कैलकुलेट जस्ट गो थ्रू दिस बिकॉज वी हैव ऑलरेडी टेकन दिस इन द क्लास मेनी टाइम्स. राइट, एंड सी यू यू आर एबल टू सी दिस क्वेश्चन इज बींग आस्क्ड इन द गेट एग्जाम ऑल्सो. सो यू कैन जस्ट अंडरस्टैंड दैट हाउ मच इम्पॉर्टेंट दिस टॉपिक्स आर. Because no doubt you all have to solve the university question paper, but at the same time, competitive exams are also that much important. It's not only about GATE, you will be giving many competitive exams. So just go through this very carefully. So base MVA we have taken as 100, base KV is 15 KV. So for generators, we have G1 as XG1 is equal to 0.25J. Multiplied by 100 upon 25. So this gives us 0.1 J per unit. Then G2, we have XG2 is equal to 0.1 J multiplied by 100 upon 100 because the rated was also 100 and the base was also 100. So that gave us the value of 0.1 J. Now let us calculate for the impedances. So rightly given by Dhanashri, KV square upon MVA, that would give us in terms of the base value, and then we will multiply this base value with the reactance part, then we will get it in the terms of the per unit value. So let us see how it will come. So for the base calculation, we have done in this way. 15 square, that is 15 KV, it was the rated voltage rating. So 15 multiplied by 15, or you can write 15 square. Divided by 100, so that give us 2.25 ohms. So this will be now converted into per unit system. Let us see how we will convert this in terms of per unit system. So 0.225 upon 2.25. So how this came, let us go back to the diagram. Then we will be able to understand. So you can see here, the positive sequence reactance is given as 0.225 ohm per kilometer. So this is the reason why we have taken here 0.225 upon 2.25, and as this is in terms of reactance, we have inserted the J part. So in this way, we get the conversion of the ohm per kilometer which was given in the data sheet in terms of the per unit system. So is it clear everyone how we have approached to this? Is it clear to everyone how this step came? Because unless and until you all will be able to calculate this, you will not be able to draw the positive sequence reactance diagram. Right? So we will require these values. Okay, repeat. So this is okay, Mayuri. Base calculation for transmission line, is this okay? This is the standard formula. Till this point, is it okay? This is the standard formula for conversion of the impedances in the transmission line. So KV square upon MVA. So we get 2.25 ohm from here. Now, what we are going to do is, we will go to the data sheet and we will check what is the positive sequence value of the transmission line. So in the data sheet, you can check from here. So you can see here in the data sheet what is given. In the data sheet, they have supplied us the positive sequence reactance as 0.225 ohm per kilometer. So be very careful. Here they have given ohm per kilometer, and the total kilometer is given as 10 kilometer. So first we will need to calculate the per unit value per kilometer, and then multiply this with 10. We will get the value for the 10 kilometer. This is what we did in most of the numericals that we did in unit 1 and unit 2. In unit 2, we have done many times this, the same procedure. So is it clear, Mayuri, now? Is it okay now? First, what we did, first we took the KV square upon MVA. So KV is 15. So 15 square upon MVA, that is 100. So that came 2.25. Then what we did, we used the positive sequence reactance value, which was supplied in the data sheet, upon the base calculation that we did. So why we did this? Because we needed to convert this in terms of per unit system. That's the only reason why we did all this calculation. Is it clear? Because here it's given in terms of ohm per kilometer. Had it been given in terms of per unit system, then we would not have done this calculation. So if there is directly given in terms of per unit system, we will not do such type of calculations. But as it was not given in per unit system, this was the only reason why we did this simple conversion. Is it clear now? Is it clear to everyone else? The part this we have already done in the first unit as well as in the second unit also. Okay. So now what we will do, we will multiply this with 10. Why multiply this with 10? Because the length of the transmission line is provided as 10 kilometer in the numerical. So 10 multiplied by x1 value. So 10 multiplied by 0.1j, that comes to 1.0j per unit. So this is done now. Is it clear, everyone? Is it clear to everyone how we have arrived to all these calculations? And now, as we have done with the L1 part, the L2 part will be also same, because L1 and L2 are one and the same thing. In the problem, L1 and L2 is of 10 kilometer, as well as the reactance is also same, 0.225 ohm per kilometer. So we need not to do the same calculations for L2 also. We have done for the case of L1. Now no need to do for L2, because for L2 also it's the same calculations. So is it clear, everyone? I expect a reply from every one of you. Is it clear to everyone how we have done all the calculations? Because we had four components, so we need to calculate four values. Out of four values, one value is getting repeated because the data sheet is given the same. So we will not going to calculate the value for L2 once again. That's why we are writing here XL1 is equal to XL2, that is equal to 1.0J per unit. So is it clear, everyone? Is it clear to everyone? Only two students are replying. What about others? There are 30 students in this class. I expect a reply from everyone. See, because this has relevance with your university question as well as with the competitive exams also. So please take all these calculations very seriously, because these all are going to make a great impact in your coming days. So please take it seriously. Okay. So now, as we are done with all the calculations, so what we will do now, we will draw the positive sequence reactance diagram. So forget about what the options are given. Remember that suppose this is a university question paper and you don't know what are the alternatives, then you will draw the diagram accordingly. So how we will draw the diagram? Let's go back to the original diagram then. So this is the original diagram. First, what we do? First, we draw the reference line. After drawing the reference line, what do we do? Then we start connecting one by one the components. So the first component is generator. We will connect the generator part with the reference bus. Then again, we will connect the generator G2 with the reference bus. Then 1 and 3, then 2 and 3. So this is a very simple diagram here which is given. So let's see how the diagram will come. We are done with all the calculation part. Let us now see how this diagram will come. So this is how the option is given to you. So you have already calculated the things. Now quickly reply me on the chat box, what will be your correct option? So you have all the values available with you. So what will be the correct option? Reply on the chat box. So you have XG1, you have XG2, you have the XL1, you have XL2, and you have the buses given denoted as 1, 3 and 2. So go through all the four options given in the question and reply on the chat box what will be the correct answer. You all have calculated it just now. So I expect a quick reply because everything is available with you. Okay, very good. So A is the correct answer. Why A is the correct answer? Because see, we have calculated x g1 as 0.10 j. We have calculated x g2 as j 0.10. We have calculated x l1 as j 1.0. And we have calculated x l2 as j 1.0. Now, one thing I need to emphasize to everyone. See here, in case of the x l1 and x l2, these two alternatives or these two options looks alike. Like you can see here, here also XL1 and XL2 is given as 1.0 only. So be very careful while selecting the correct alternative. Is it clear everyone? Because after checking, if you will see this is XL1, this is XL2. So if you will blindly go to the option B and make it as a B, so your answer will become wrong. Why? Because you need to check XG1 and XG2 also, right? So in this way, the tricky questions are asked and the tricky alternatives are also given in the competitive question papers. So you need to be very careful. First, do your own calculations and then go for choosing the correct one. Is it clear, everyone? So this was the one of the question that we did in our unit 1 as well as unit 2 also. So now you can see how it's important to do the things very seriously. Just don't do the subjects with the perspective of the university question papers, but prepare the subjects for the lifelong activity, right? Because this all will help you to do the things in your competitive exams also. So the correct option for this particular question is option A, right? So in this way, we come to know how the gate questions are asked in the university, in terms of your university question papers also, and in terms of the gate question papers also. So is it clear, everyone? Is there any difficulty to solve this question to anyone? Will there be any difficulty to solve this question with anyone? So the correct option is A. Okay. So now let's go to the next question. I have already said that in this 2011 question paper, there were two questions which were linked to the same data sheet which is provided in the question. So the same data sheet is provided in the question and one more question is asked with the help of the same data sheet. So let's see what is the question. Is it done, everyone? Shall we go to the next slide? Shall we go to the next question related to this? Okay. So let's go to the next question. So this is the next question which is coming up in the next slide. In the next question, previous question we have seen in question number 52. So in the 2011 GATE question paper, question number 52 was asked with the help of this question. Now, let's go to the next question, which is linked to this. Next question is question number 53. So, the diagram is the same as I have already said. Diagram which is provided for this particular question is same. And what they have asked is just look at it. We have already solved this question also, right? So, what is asked is in the above system, the three-phase fault MVA at bus 3, right? So you can see here what they are giving. They are giving that a fault has occurred at bus 3. So be very careful where the fault has occurred. The fault has occurred at bus number 3. So we need to calculate ZTH as we used to calculate while calculating the fault current. I hope you every one of you remember the equation of the fault current in case of the symmetrical fault. So in case of the symmetrical fault, the equation of the fault current is आई एफ इज इक्वल टू 1.0 अपॉन जेड टी एच एंड वेन एवर वी यूज टू कैलकुलेट द फॉल्ट एम वी ए वी रिक्वायर्ड दिस पर्टिक्युलर जेड टी एच सो दैट्स वाई वी विल बी रिक्वायरिंग दिस जेड टी एच बिकॉज देन वी नीड टू मल्टीप्लाई दिस जेड टी एच विद द बेस एम वी ए सो वंस वी मल्टीप्लाई दिस जेड टी एच विद द बेस एम वी ए we easily get the fault MVA. So I hope you all remember this because we have already solved some questions related to this. So now let's calculate the ZTH then. So this is your positive sequence reactance diagram. So we have already selected this with the previous question, that is question number 52. So in question number 52, we have already selected the option A and the option A was in this way. So XG1, XL1, XL2 and XG2. Now we are being given that the fault has occurred at bus number 3. So where will be your point F? So your point F will be here. So if the point F is here, can anyone tell me what this complete circuit will become? Will it be everything in series or this portion in series and this portion is in series and the combination of this portion and this portion in parallel with each other? Can anyone reply on the chat box? How we will analyze this point? So the fault point is now here. You can see the fault point is in the midpoint. So here there is the fault point. So how do we calculate ZTH? Will it be the complete combination in series or will it be this portion in series, this portion in series and the combination of this portion in parallel with each other? Second one, very good Aniket. So if we consider the fault point here, fault point is here and whenever the fault point is there, we can consider the fault point is also connected with the ground, right? So, if the fault point is connected with the ground, then you can see here the fault point will have in this way, that is J0.10 plus J1.0 in parallel with J1.0 plus J0.10. Is it clear, everyone? So, quickly calculate ZTH and reply on the chat box. What will be the value of ZTH? ZTH will be, see, the fault has occurred at bus number 3. So, location of F is at bus 3. So, how do we calculate the ZTH? ZTH will be equal to J0.10 plus J1.0 in parallel with J1.0 plus J0.10. So, calculate it first and reply on the chat box what would be the value of ZTH. Because once we get the value of ZTH, then only we can calculate the fault MVA. So it's not correct, Aniket. Okay, let me check Aniket. So fault MVA is equal, this is the formula actually, let's calculate ZTH. Okay, right Aniket. Sorry Aniket, your answer is correct. J0.55 per unit. Now you can have this formula with you, fault MVA. Fault MVA is equal to MVA base upon ZTH as we did previously. So you can substitute the value and you can calculate the fault MVA. So fault MVA is equal to 100 upon 0.55. I have omitted the J part because anyways, if I will take the J, it will be at an angle minus 90 degree and we are not concerned with the J or the, we are only concerned with the magnitude part in case of the fault MVA. So, your fault MVA comes as 181.82 MVA. So, now tell me what will be the correct alternative then. So, you all have the question with you. This is the question available with you. So, reply on the chat box, what will be the correct answer then? Right, so the correct answer will be D. So, is it clear everyone how the things are being asked in the competitive examination. These are the same things that you have learnt in your unit number 2. So just do the things very carefully and just don't read the subject or prepare the subject for only the university point of view. You can see if you are able to apply the correct knowledge, then you can solve the competitive exams as well. So you can see very easily you are able to solve the question for 4 marks, right? Because this question are being asked for 2 marks each. So you are able to solve the question for 4 marks. And 4 marks is a very important score in a GATE like examination, because in a GATE examination, you have to be very careful regarding your questions, because there are negative marking also, and your score is depending on all such parameters. So is it done? We have solved today the 2 questions related to the electrical power system, which is asked in the GATE question paper for 2011. So in this way, the correct option is, the correct option would be D here. I have somehow written it A, so let me correct it. So the correct answer is D. Okay. Okay. Now take this question. This will be a homework for all of you. This will be a homework for all of you. Please take this question. This is also asked in one of the GATE question paper in 2010. And this also you all have done. So there is nothing like that you have not done. So please note down this question. Then we will take what is the question associated with this, what is being asked in the GATE question paper related to this question. Okay, so done. Has everyone noted the question? Okay, so let's see what is the question for this. So the question is in this way: choose 25 kV as the base voltage at the generator G1 and 200 MVA as the base MVA, and draw the impedance diagram. This is what is the question which is associated with this. We will see what are the alternatives for this question. This you all have to do at your home. So the procedure is the same. You all know how to draw the positive sequence reactance diagram. All the values associated to this is already given. So you all have to solve this question. Let us see what are the alternatives given for this question. So, has everyone noted the question? Shall we go to the alternative? Because I need to change the PDF. I need to share the question paper of 2010. From there, we have to note the alternatives. The MCQs which are given will be shared in the question paper. I'll be sharing the question paper. Just a minute. So, please note down the alternatives one by one. A and B I have shared. You can draw this in your book. Alternative A and alternative B I have shared on the screen. You can draw this. You can draw this in your copy. Once you are done, reply on the chat box. Then I will show the alternative C and D. Okay, so done. Shall we go to the C and D options? So these are the C and D options. So just try this at your home and reply the answers in the next lectures. We will take one more question after this. A simple question related to the short circuit current. So done with the alternatives, shall we go to the next question? We will quickly take another question, a very simple question which is again asked in one of the gate question paper related to the short circuit current. So over, shall we go to the next question? So this is the next question. So this is the question available. So a 10 kVA 400 volt by 200 volt single phase transformer with 10% impedance draws a steady short circuit line current of alternatives is 50, 150, 250 and 350. So this was asked in the GATE 1999 question paper. The solution is very simple. So as this is a single phase transformer, we are not going to make use of the symmetrical fault analysis that we did. So, okay, in the previous question, B is the answer. So Aniket has also solved it. Okay, so let others also solve it. We will discuss in next session. So let others also solve this, Aniket. We will discuss it in the next session, which is the correct alternative. Okay, so note down this question. So as this is a single phase transformer, we are not going with the symmetrical fault analysis that we did. We are going to simply make use of our knowledge that we done in the previous part. So simply we have 10 kVA. So 10 kVA means 10 into 10 to the power 3 upon 200, because the load will be there in the secondary part. It will be not there in the primary part. So short circuit line current will be there in the secondary part. So that's why I have written here 200. So 10 into 10 to the power 3 upon 200, that comes 50 ampere. So in this way, today we have done some of the problems which were asked in the GATE question paper. In the coming days, we will see few more problems. So I hope everyone have noted this question.